Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas. Holidays, special notes, special series. A new note on blink, the power of thinking without thinking, by Malcolm Gladwell. Malcolm Gladwell is an established classic, one of the best psychologists and authors. His two volumes, Blink and Outliers, are among the most mentioned influential books that I can think of in the field of psychology. And from what I find on the net and reading in The Economist, it's not just me. Many people are fascinated by this author and his books. There was an article in The Economist some time ago, but I think it's this year, mentioning the Harding effect. The fact that the CEOs in the top 500 companies and most likely elsewhere, not just the top tier, but elsewhere, are very tall, much taller than the average, and that will support the theory that we make decisions and pass judgments in the blink of an eye. Well, if not exactly in the blink of an eye, so quickly, in what has to do with the CEO, but the moment he comes into the room, because the, referring again to this example, the CEOs, the leaders of companies and countries, speaking of that, the CVs of other candidates are obviously as impressive, but they just lack this first impact. First impression, which counts for a lot. The theory is called, behind this, is called thin slicing, and it's not just a second, but it's not what we would think. In fact, we have a proverb which says "Paren silent shallow." Here, I'm thinking if there is a version in English, it must be, I just don't know it, and indeed it's in other places a thought, appearances deceive, you should not judge a book by its cover. That's one, that's a version I can think of now, but then that's wrong. I mean, a book can tell you a lot from its cover. If it's Dan Brown, you know what you're getting. Same thing with the Harry Potter. You're not going to get the philosophy of Spinoza. I was considering earlier my own experience. I came to the conclusion after working in the hospitality business, as they call it today, industry, travel and tours side of industry, so to say. I was coming to the conclusion that having to deal with so many people, over 10,000, maybe over 20,000, and over 1,000 in close contact, actually. I had quite a few groups of 40, and my way of approaching this business was to, first of all, get to know them. I would get the list and keep calling Mr. Klein, Mr. De Souza. I remember I liked this name for some reason, Portuguese, exotic sounding, Mr. De Souza. And the man was a nice gentleman. Joan Foster, she came back. Anyway, so trying to be close to them, I don't think they taught us in the communist school, but I had a hunch that being close to the customer would help, and it didn't help. But then I drew a line, and said, well, it must be this business. I came to the conclusion that I can say if I like a person or not once he's coming into the sauna. A few steps, look at the face, and it was enough. And I was thinking it's because I had to schmooze to shake hands and talk to so many. And this helped, and it gave me an extra sense. One coming into the bus or the car, I would say this is going to be okay or this is going to be trouble. But then I didn't realize that it's not wasn't just me or this industry, it's Blink, the power of thinking without thinking, to which I will have to come back with another note.